is Ruth, and today I'm going to show how to make a heart coil dish like this. So in about an hour's time, you'll be able to make it, paint it with underglaze, and then I will take it here to my studio where I have a kiln, and I'll fire it, and it'll get back to you in a couple of weeks. So you're going to get a kit that looks like this, and everything you need should be in there. So the first thing we want to do is prepare our base. So there are several options. I don't know if you can see this. So you can decide which one you would like, or you can make your own shape, but I'm going to do the heart. So grab some scissors and quickly cut out the piece of paper in the shape of a heart. Simple shapes work the best. So I've got a heart shape. Now you're going to get a piece of clay that looks like this. It's a slab. So you want to get that out. Put it on your mat. And then just lay your shape on top and grab a pencil and draw around it. You don't have to draw very hard, just gently. And then we're gonna get a butter knife. Everyone should have one of these at home, and they're not sharp, so don't worry. And you wanna cut your project, your base, and see how I hold the knife straight up and down? That works the best, rather than like this. I'm just cutting all the way through. To sort of tap the edges if they seem like they're going to be sharp. Just kind of smooth that off a little bit. So here's your heart, and you're ready for the next step. The next thing we want to do is get some extra clay. So there should be plenty of clay to do the project. And this is something you can make as big as you want. This is a kind of a small one, but yours could be bigger. So you want to get some clay off, pinch off about that much, and then start it in your hand. We're going to make a coil, and then do it on your mat, or if you want, right on the table. Sometimes it's easier. Notice my fingers are fanning and stretching and making this a little bit bigger. And this is probably a good size. You might want to make a couple of coils, and then you can build up your sides. So I'll do that. So I roll slow. If you roll really fast, sometimes you'll end up breaking your piece, which isn't that big a deal because clay is really easy to fix. You can always just squish it back up. So the next thing we're going to do is attach these coils. And so what we need for that is slip. Sorry, I have to take a drink. So in a yogurt container, we have some slip. Slip is just clay and water mixed together. And it works kind of like glue for clay. So you also have a fork. So you want to dip your fork in and then tap off the extra because you don't want to use a lot of slip. Just want to have a little bit. So I'm going to scratch. Notice how I'm really digging in. I want to make a pretty good mark. If you don't do it hard enough, it won't stick together right. So you do that on your heart, and then you also scratch your coils. And it doesn't have to be perfect. So what I like to start is right here. I'll take one end of my piece. I don't need to worry about how big it is. And I just press it down right on top of those scratch marks. And then when I get to a corner, I turn it. And this piece happens to be exactly the right size, but it doesn't have to be. You can always use another piece to fill it. So now I need to scratch again because I always want to scratch when I attach. It works like kind of like a zipper, so the clay pieces stick together like that. Again, I've already scratched my coil and start where I left off and I press down. You don't want to squish it flat, but you do want to press it down a little bit so that it really joins together. And again, that one turned out to be exactly the right size, but if it isn't, you just take off a little piece to fill in a gap. You can have different sizes of coils, it doesn't matter. So I'm going to build it up one more coil. You can make yours as tall as you want. I recommend doing at least three. Again, I have to scratch when I attach. Okay, start where I left off, and I'm just gonna stick it down, make sure it's really stuck on there. Okay, so now I'm gonna say I'm done building up my walls. You can make yours as big as you want, but it's always a good idea to smooth, at least on the inside. So let me show you what that means. Not sure how well you can see this, but you want to sort of move the clay into the cracks. I'll do it on the outside because I think it's easier to see. So I'm moving the clay into the cracks. I'm smoothing it down so I don't have any rough edges. And I would do that all the way around. I'm not going to do that because it'll take too long. Next step is decorating. So you'll get some little tools. And the stuff in here just will make a texture on the clay. So you can start by putting a design on the inside, maybe. I like hearts. Put a couple of hearts in there. You could roll some corn to make a bumpy corn texture. Even a pencil could be really good. You can make little dots with it. I've got tires. I have pasta. People like to use beads. With the beads, you need to make sure you press them in really well. And then pull them out. You get a little bumpy design. So that's decorating. Now you're ready to paint. So what you want to do is get a board, which will be in your kit, and you're going to put your project on a board and fold up your mat at that point. You'll have a few colors to choose from. And you can use them all, or one or two, it's up to you. Okay, so when you're ready to paint, the one thing you want to remember is anything you don't paint will be white and shiny. So you don't have to paint every single inch of it, but wherever you paint, it'll be nice and bright. You want to put a pretty thick coat on, so I'm gonna show this is red and it comes out really bright. So you can do lightly, or you can really make it thick. It depends on what you want it to look like. And I'm not going to paint the whole thing, but think about what colors look good together, maybe. Or if you're making it for somebody, what colors they like. So you can paint everything you see, but don't paint the underneath. That part would get stuck to the kiln shelf. So just keep the project on the board while you're painting. You might need to lean over to look and see what you're doing. And make sure you got all the spots that you wanted to get. If you want it really bright, you can even wait till it dries a bit and add a second coat. Please don't mix the colors in here. I want to keep these because the glazes are very expensive, so return any unused glaze that you don't need. When you're all done painting, and you want to let this dry just a little bit so it's not tacky or wet to the touch. And then slip it inside a bag that will be included in your thing. And that way it'll stay nice and moist so I can write your names on it when I get these back and make sure they don't break on the wood. And make sure your name is on the board or the bag with a Sharpie so I'll know whose project it is. And that is how to make a hard coil dish.